With the newly released Policy Maps website, you can now quickly and easily explore and share policy maps that matter to you and to your city. You might be wondering, what's the difference between a regular map and a policy map? Well, policy maps clearly show where there are opportunities to intervene. This site is full of maps that are meaningful at a glance. Here you can discover how other organizations are tackling today's community challenges, such as the opioid epidemic, crime, and poverty. This website is freely available to anybody, whether you're an elected official, city employee, or citizen. So here's a situation you might have experienced before. Someone requests information on a particular subject or policy, and they need it by the end of the day. With a policy map site, you can quickly find information and can easily share it through an email like this one that includes maps of interest. When they click on the URL, they see the map collection you've prepared. Here we have a series of 8 maps related to the population in Los Angeles, California. People can explore these maps to gain new insight into their city, such as the most common language spoken at home, as seen in this map. The blue areas have mostly English-speaking households, whereas the purple areas are mostly Spanish-speaking. The red symbols represent Asian and Pacific Islander languages. People can share this out through a URL, Facebook, Twitter, or through email. This ability to find information on any city, any geography, and on hundreds of variables is something I know people are very excited about. Now, if you would like this too, let me show you how to create a policy map collection for your city. In the Policy Maps website, enter your city and explore a sample topic below. Imagine I'm a school administrator from the city of Atlanta, Georgia. And I'd like to start by exploring the topic of education. So let's see what the Policy Maps website can show me about my city. We are presented with 5 maps related to education. In this map, the lighter colored areas in South Atlanta have a higher percentage of people who started college but didn't finish. The next map answers the question, where are the disconnected youth? That is, kids age 16 to 19 who are neither in school nor in the workforce. Let's explore additional topics related to education. I'll select the issue of poverty. This map shows the percentage of children living below the poverty level. What I appreciate about this map is that it not only shows me the percent, but also the number. For example, in this area, over 2,000 kids are living below the poverty line. Issues that matter to Atlanta also matter to other cities like Houston, Texas, where we see striking patterns of poverty around the city, with the exception of West Houston. Many of these maps have national coverage and are multi-scale, which means they're available at the state, county, tract, and block group levels. So let's clear this map collection and build our own. In this case, I'm interested in issues related to affordable housing in Denver, Colorado. I can view this nationwide map that shows low-income households in yellow and higher-income households in red and purple. When I zoom into Denver, I see greater detailed information about the households in the area. I know decision makers would find value in this map, so I'm going to add it to my map collection. What is the rent like in Denver? Well, areas in pink have a higher percentage of rentals, whereas areas in blue have a lower percentage. I know people will like this one as well, so I'll collect it. I'd also like to add the owner-occupied housing and home value map, as well as the renter-occupied housing map, giving us a total of 4 maps in my collection that I can share through an email like you saw earlier. When someone clicks on the URL, they see the four maps that I was just looking at related to affordable housing in Denver, Colorado. So let's take a deeper dive into the issues by looking at examples of story maps, apps, lessons, and more. These are organized by topic so that you can see what others are mapping, analyzing, and sharing. The difference between this and open data is that it's constantly sharing the value added. You can open these maps as a starting point to do your analysis and continue your work. Let's add the alternative fuel stations to the map viewer and customize it for the city of St. Louis. You can zoom into the city, add a filter, and add additional layers of interest. With a quick drive time analysis and geo-enrichment, we see that 73% of people within the St. Louis area have access to an alternative fuel station within 10 minutes of their home. So, what good is this information if you can't share your story? Well, you can take these web maps and author your own personal story map. A major part of policy mapping is helping people identify with the issue by making it personal. How does this relate to me? Story maps help people experience the personal side of an issue and your proposed policy solution through engaging narrative, images, and powerful maps. This is living data. It's constant, evolved, and updating. It's freely available at esri.com/policymaps. Maps help us navigate from place to place. Esri is producing a higher level of navigation for policy and for everyone.